Great atmosphere in here tonight, but the pressure is on as the X Factor and Michael Jackson songs for a place in the X Factor final. Next up, last for the boys, which means we go to his mentor and his Geordie soulmate, Cheryl Cole.
Next, let's sing one of the most beautiful Michael Jackson songs. It's my pleasure to introduce Joel McElderry. You absolutely...
I still can't get my head around the fact that I'm in the semi-final. Ever since I knew I could sing, all I've ever wanted to do is be a superstar.
Where?
All his life, Joel's wanted to sing and perform and be a star. And I am very, very proud to be part of him fulfilling that dream.
First live shows, Joe was a great singer, but now he's starting to stand out more and more.
But I still haven't got the dream. I've got to take them final steps to get there.
He's got an incredible tone to his voice, and he's always, always just about note perfect.
He's just a normal kid with a massive dream, and he's desperate to achieve it.
The final takes me within touch and distance of everything that I've wanted, and I've got to get there.
Joel McElderry.
I don't know whether to laugh or cry. I don't know whether to live or die. And it cuts like a knife. She's out of my life. So I've learned that love's not possessed. Now I've learned that love needs expression, but I've learned too late, and she's out of my life. She's out of my life. Damned indecision and cursed pride kept my love for her locked deep inside, and it cuts like a knife. She is out of my life.
Simon said you have an amazing tone to your voice, and Joe, the thing about you is you'd have an amazing recording voice, and if you won, if you got into the final and won the competition, you could sell millions of records. I think you have the talent. You obviously need the vote, but you're the most consistent performer in the competition, and there's a big, big gap in the market for somebody like you. Absolutely.
Thank
so you. I think you've got it all, but you need the vote.
Thank you,
Joe, you have just clocked up another superb performance. Nerves, because you just sing like a dream. I can definitely agree with Louis that I could hear you all over the radio, all over records. You're going to do very, very well. You have to be in the final.
It's becoming incredibly repetitive, this, which is annoying, but you're just getting better and better and better.
versions of that song before. It's, you know, apart from obviously Michael, it's one of the best versions of the song I've ever heard because it was just so stripped down. The latter part, when you changed the tone of your voice, it was absolutely on the money. It felt like it meant something to you. I'm really proud of you, Joe, what you've achieved in this one.
It was chilling. It was everything it needed to be. Passionate, emotional. Honestly, Joe, I think that was even better than anything you've ever done before, if that's possible.
Wow.
Well, semi-final. I was going to ask you, feeling the pressure? Pressure? What pressure? How you feeling?
Yeah, there's big time pressure. I was so nervous before coming on, but I'm just trying my best, and that's all I can do.
Simon said it's one of the best versions of that song he's ever heard. It's such a hard Michael Jackson song to sing as well, isn't it?
Yeah, and it's quite an emotional one as well. It's really emotional.
What are you talking about? You got your own stool. Pop stars, look at that. You know you made it when you got your own stool. Like me in Westlife. 0901 6161 102. Number to call when lines open if you want to see this little fella's cheeky smile light up the final of the X Factor. But now, it's Joe McKeldry.